guys, it's me, Jennifer, from Adventures in Storytime, and it's been a while since I've done one of these because I've been busy moving all the way across the country to start a new position, and that's why I don't have the best place to record right now because I am staying in an Airbnb until my new house is ready, so bear with me. But I couldn't let Halloween pass us by without doing another video and sharing some fun songs and rhymes and book suggestions. All right, so are we ready? Okay, now our first one is one you probably already know, but there are several different variations and it's always fun to do, and it's the Five Little Pumpkins. So let's get our counting fingers ready. You got your five little pumpkins, are we ready? All right. Five little pumpkins sitting on a gate. The first one said, "Oh my, it's getting late." The second one said, "There are bats in the air." The third one said, "But we don't care." The fourth one said, "Oh, let's run and run and run." The fifth one said, "I'm ready for some fun." Then whoosh went the wind and out went the light. And the five little pumpkins rolled out of sight. All right, let's do that one more time because that one's nice and short and fun. And the way you learned it might be a little different than the way I do it, so we'll do it one more time together now that you've seen how I do it. Are you ready? We got our five little pumpkins ready. All right. Five little pumpkins sitting on a gate. The first one said, "Oh my, it's getting late." The second one said, "There are bats in the air." The third one said, "But we don't care." The fourth one said, "Let's run and run and run." The fifth one said, "I'm ready for some fun." Then whoosh went the wind and out went the light. The five little pumpkins rolled out of sight. You think they got scared when the lights went out? Sometimes all the noises can be a lot scarier when it's dark, can't it? All right, now I have one more to do with pumpkins. And this one's a song, and the tune is to a classic, "Have You Ever Seen a Lassie?" Now again, you'll have to bear with me. I am now living in a high altitude area, and it's made my not so great singing voice even a little less not so great. All right, so this one is, "Have You Ever Seen a Pumpkin?" Have you ever seen a pumpkin, a pumpkin, a pumpkin? Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? There are short ones and tall ones and big ones and small ones. Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? Now I have some more of these pumpkin faces that we're going to use for the next verse, but first we're going to go through and talk about what feeling they are showing. So what is this pumpkin? This one is showing happy. Can I see your happy face? Oh, let me see. Oh, lots of nice happy faces out there. Great. Now what is this one showing? Oh, is it? That's right, he's sad. Can I see your sad face? Oh, so sad. Now, what about this one? Ooh, this one is maybe mad or scary. Can you show me your scary face? Let me see. Ooh, that's a really scary face you made. Now, this one is showing, what? How's he feeling? He's feeling silly. Now, I know you have a silly face. Let me see your silly faces. Oh, good job. So we are going to use these in the next verse of our song. Are you ready? So, have You ever seen a pumpkin, a pumpkin, a pumpkin? Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? There are happy ones and sad ones and scary ones and silly ones. Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? All right, now this time, instead of showing the pumpkins, I want you to show me your faces. All right, so we're gonna start all over. We'll do the first verse and the second verse, and the second time you can make the funny faces. Are you ready? Have you ever seen a pumpkin, a pumpkin, a pumpkin? Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? There are short ones and tall ones and big ones and small ones. Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? Have you ever seen a pumpkin, a pumpkin, a pumpkin? Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? There are happy ones and sad ones and scary ones and silly ones. Have you ever seen a pumpkin that grows on a vine? All right, great job. Now I have one more. And Halloween wouldn't be complete without a ghost. All right, so we are gonna do a fun rhyme with ghost, and you can make a ghost with, I'm just using a white washcloth. You can use a lot of different things. You could use a clean handkerchief, you could use a Kleenex, you could use a movement scarf, you can use lots of different things, or you can even just pretend. So let's get our ghost going. Now you can stand up to do this one. I'm going to stay seated so you can see me. As if I stood up, you wouldn't be able to see me on the camera, but you can stand up to do this. Now we're gonna get our ghost flying. So get our ghost flying around. Make your ghost sounds. Ooh. Are you ready? And here's how it goes. Little ghost, flying through the air. Little ghost, tickling my hair. Little ghost, flying way down low. Little ghost, tickling my toes. Make your ghost tickle your toes. Little ghost, flying all around. Little ghost, please sit down. Of course, I'm already sitting down. All right, so now that you've seen it, we'll do it one more time really quick. You ready? Get your ghost flying, and let's get our ghost noises. Ooh. Little ghost, flying through the air. Little ghost, tickling my hair. Little ghost, flying way down low. Little ghost, tickling our toes. Little ghost, flying all around. Little ghost, please sit down. Great job. All right, give yourselves a hand. Wasn't that fun? I really like the little ghost. All right, now it is time for me to share some books that you might want to get from your library and read at home. All right, the first one I'm gonna start with is great for younger kids. This is Duck and Goose Find a Pumpkin by Tad Hill. Sorry for the reflection there. And this is great for little kids because there's nothing spooky or scary about it. This is just a nice story, a little silly, about two friends going to pick out their Halloween pumpkin. But they don't know where to find a pumpkin, and they look in all kinds of strange places, like in a hollow log, in a pile of leaves, in the apple tree. Do you find pumpkins growing on an apple tree? No. And finally, they figure out the best place to find a pumpkin. And you can read this and see which one they pick. All right, our next one is my personal favorite, and it's a classic. The Little Old Lady Who Is Not Afraid of Anything. And this is written by Linda Williams and illustrated by Megan Lloyd. So in this story, our brave little old lady is out in the woods gathering nuts and herbs, and she stays out just a little bit too late. It starts to get dark. But is she scared? No, she's not afraid of anything. But then all of a sudden, she hears something behind her. What could it be? It is two shoes going clomp, clomp behind her. And then she goes a little further and finds the shoes are following her. And then there's a pair of pants going wiggle, wiggle. And she keeps going, and all these things keep following her. But at the end, it's a big surprise. Now, this book is fun, and it's great because there is an element of suspense and one place where you can get to scare them just a little, but in the end, it turns out to not be scary at all. And this is my favorite. I never get tired of reading it, and I haven't gotten a chance to read it for the last couple of years, so I'm really missing it. Now, our next one is another classic that I have to share because it happens to have been a favorite of my daughter's. And this one is The Halloweener. And in this story, our little dog, who happens to be a dachshund, or what some people call a hot dog or a wiener dog, and his name is Oscar. Well, he got teased by the other dogs because his little legs were so short and he was so low to the ground. And they teased him about being a wiener dog, and he did not like it one bit. But it was time for Halloween, and Oscar was excited because that meant trick-or-treat, and he had planned a great spooky, scary costume. But when he gets home, he finds his mother has already gotten him a costume, and look what it is. Oh no, it is literally a hot dog costume. Oh, poor Oscar. He knew the other dogs would really tease him, but he didn't want to hurt his mother's feelings. But in the end, it turns out the costume was just right. So this is a great book, and this is good for adults too and older kids because it has a lot of puns in it that the younger ones won't get, but it's a nice little treat for the adults reading it. And then finally, I have one extra suggestion since it is a holiday. And this is Halloween Night by Marjorie Dennis Murray, and the illustrations are by Brandon Norman. And this one is done in the same rhythm as Twas a Night Before Christmas. So it starts out, okay, like this. Twas Halloween night, and all through the house, every creature was stirring, including the mouse. The walls were aflutter with little brown bats, with hordes of black spiders crept out of the cracks. By the fire in the kitchen, the witch stirred her brew. To make it more smelly, she threw in a shoe. So this is a lot of fun, and it's a familiar rhythm and shows lots of different creatures. So kids will really like this one too. So I hope everyone has a happy and safe Halloween, and I will see you next time, and thank you for joining me today. See you later.